What's up, guys? Ninth Jim here, back with another VGC 2020 Pokemon Sword and Shield competitive video. Today, we're talking about Ninetales, the regular Ninetales, Cantonian Ninetales. I've made a video on Alolan Ninetales before, and it did pretty well, and these Pokemon play pretty similar. They set the weather for their team, essentially. This one can set Drought, setting the intense sun, instead of setting Hail, which the other one does, the Alolan Ninetales does, and yeah, other than that, they're pretty similar. The stats differ just barely. I think this one has more defense or more like, what is it? Is it defense? No, more attack. That's very useless. When Alolan Ninetales gets a little bit faster. So it has a better stats in that regard because we don't even use attack. But oh well, it is what it is, you know, it's whatever. But they do have different typing, different move pools, very different Pokemon. However, their ability is similar how they just set weather. So the ability Drought sets the sun for your team. You can use things like Charizard, Venusaur to really take advantage of that with Chlorophyll and Solar Power. Very, very powerful things. You can even use Leafeon, you know? A whole bunch of really cool Pokemon that you can use that really gain a lot out of Drought, which is cool. And other than that, this Pokemon is pretty plain and simple. Just deal some damage. Is pretty fast. Is like relatively fast. And it's pretty good. So let's talk about it. So Fire-type Pokemon. Regular just fire type, pretty solid, you know, 6 resistances. We have fire, grass, ice, bug, steel, fairy, and then 3 weaknesses at water, ground, and rock. Overall, not that bad. You know, we have a lot of attacks that are weakness, you know, water, ground, rock, 3 of the bigger types in the meta currently. Very, very big prevalent types. However, I mean, we get two-shotted by just about anything. We're insanely frail, and not insanely frail, actually, like 73 HP, 75 defense, and 100 special defense. We're very mediocre. Like, very average amount of defense and bulk in general. Very average. Which is fine with this Pokemon, because we're using Focus Sash, so we pretty much just die to 2 hits no matter what. Like, it's typically going to be 2 hits. Unless they're resisted hits, then we might not take that much damage, but then it still breaks our Sash, and then it doesn't really matter. But yeah, overall, not bad typing. Other than our bulk stats, we also have other stats. Obviously, 76 attack and 81 special attack. I wish we had like half of our attack put into our special attack. That'd be crazy, but we don't. So very just minimal stats, pretty average. 81 special attack is not that bad, and 100 speed is not bad. It's not great. It's not bad. Actually, it's pretty great. Like, it's pretty solid. 167 is our speed tier with all of our increases, and it's not bad at all. All right, so that's going to be it for our overview. We'll go ahead and talk about the actual build itself with this Pokemon. Let me get very small here because we have a lot of moves that are good. Like, a lot of moves that are good. So we'll talk about that in a moment. So first off, we have ability. This is wrong. Ability is wrong. Actually, whoops. That's supposed to be Drought. I'm silly. Make that. Whoops. What? I said black. I said black. There we go. Alright. Haha. You thought Flash Fire. You thought I was going Flash Fire. No, you didn't. You probably didn't. But oh well. It's Flash Fire. It's not Drought. So Drought is pretty good. It sets the sun. I've said that like 3 times now, so we're not going to talk about that anymore. Ability Drought is good. Item, Focus Sash. Just being not super bulky, so we'll go ahead and just take an attack and then set another attack. This Pokemon has a lot of really good attacks, and it's pretty cool to be able to attack twice, maybe even once if your opponent double targets or hits you once and then multi-targeting move like Dazzling Gleam or Rock Slide. But in general, I think Focus Sash is definitely the optimal usage, the optimal item for this Pokemon. You can always go with something else. You can go with Choice Scarf. That's the other item that you may want to use. I still think Focus Sash is way better, but I mean, to each his own. Anyway, so moves: Heat Wave, Solar Beam, Fake Tears, and Protect all are pretty solid. This is the move set we're going with right now. You can definitely switch some out. I like Heat Wave and Solar Beam as our attacks. Heat Wave just being our stab move, hitting 2 Pokemon at once is pretty good. Heat Wave is good. I like it a lot. I think it's good. And then we also have Solar Beam, which is just since we set Drought with our ability Drought, we get to attack Solar Beam for free. So when your opponent brings out a water type, they're like, haha, I can deal with this team. You're like, oh, Solar Beam, got him. You know, it's pretty good. So Solar Beam's a good option. And then for our support move, we have Fake Tears, and then we also have Protect. I like Fake Tears. I think it's good. You can even run one speed less on your Charizard or something, because they're on the same speed tier, so that you can fake tiers and then max Airstream or something for a lot of value. That's definitely an option that you can go with the Ninetales. A lot of teams will have Torkoal as their sun setter. It doesn't really matter, you can go either way. However, with that, you kind of need like a trick room mode then too, and this doesn't require that. This kind of just gives you like a fast mode as your whole team, and you can just play the team very fast, which is cool. Fake tiers is really good. It just lowers their special defense by 2, making your Venusaur and Charizard and even itself just deal insane damage to anything. So that's like just a really good option. And then we have Protect, just to let this Pokemon last a little longer, you know, protect on the turn where our Focus Sash is broken and we're about to die. You protect and then kill whatever threat with your Charizard or Venusaur or whatever Pokemon you have next to the Ninetales. It's just a good option. You don't have to use it. You don't have to use Fake Tears. You don't have to use Solar Beam or Heat Wave, honestly, but that is the set that I'm going with here. As far as other flex moves go, all these moves are insane, like right above me. They're all really good. So starting them off, we have Will-O-Wisp, which is good. It just burns things, which is good. Hypnosis, which just sleeps things, which is good. Are you seeing a trend? Like, they're all good. Will-O-Wisp, Hypnosis. We have Roar to switch out Pokemon that have like really crazy stat buffs or anything. I saw this. I actually used it for a little while. Arcanine with Roar at the beginning of Sword and Shield format. Just being able to deal with certain Pokemon really easily. Things like Mudsdale were really problematic for my team. So I was like, all right, Roar just deals with that. Roar deals with a couple of like just random Pokemon that get really like annoying and it's hard to beat. You know, things like Weakness Posse, you can just Roar them out, which is good. I like it. Safeguard, we have just protecting all of our Pokemon from status, which is pretty good. Nasty Plot, making this Pokemon insane. Special attack damage dealing Pokemon. It's pretty cool. In our singles build for this Pokemon, we have the Nasty Plot, a couple of attacks build. So Nasty Plot's good. We have Encore as well, hitting things like Trick Room, set up Pokemon. Very good move in general. We have Shadow Ball, Dark Pulse. Both as good coverage moves that are special attack. They're pretty solid. Then we have Foul Play, playing off your opponent's physical attack, which is good as well. Overheat as a different option to Heat Wave, and Energy Ball as a different option to Solar Beam. Both of them are good. They do a lot of damage. Overheat does more damage, but it's not both. It's not multi-targeting. It also has lower accuracy. It also has the guarantee of you dropping your special attack by 2, which is unfortunate, but it is what it is, you know, with it being like 150, 140 base power move. It's insane. Then we have Energy Ball, just so in case we don't have to set our Drought. The only bad thing about being a fast weather setter is that things like the Tyranitar, Pelipper, all of those Pokemon switch the weather if they lead it and you lead, because yours will activate first and theirs will activate second, unless it's like Scarf Tyranitar, which would suck. But it is what it is. So, some other options there that you can go with. Then we have our investments here, our stats. We're going with 252 into special attack, 252 into speed. Very basic, just very fast and doing as much damage as possible. There's no real point in going into any of our bulk since we're very, very not bulky and using Focus Sash. So we're essentially just like letting ourselves die after 1 to 2 hits, or after 2 hits. Or one like super effective hit and then like Sandstorm Tick or Hail Tick or something like that. But really 2 hits. So like going into HP or anything else, we'd probably just die to 2 hits anyway, like 2 super effective hits. So it's really just going into speed and special attack. And we want to go into speed, like max speed anyway, just because we want to be as fast as possible. So yeah, that's about it for the build. Synergetic Pokemon come pretty much as no surprise. We have Solar Power Charizard, which just gets Life Orb boost essentially when used under Sun. So you use Life Orb or Charcoal or something like that, or even Chardiberry or anything. That just helps you from dying. So you use something that makes you strong. The ability makes you strong. You Gigantamax and make this Pokemon insane. Like, Charizard's a very good option with Ninetales. Or just Torkoal, Sunsetters, anything like that. And then we also have Venusaur, which now has Chlorophyll, which is insane because Chlorophyll is insane. Just doubles your speed, making the Pokemon an absolute fast Pokemon with Sleep Powder and very threatening special attacks, which is good. That's about it for this slide. We'll go ahead and talk about some speed tiers. So for speed tiers, we have 167 for Charizard and Ninetales. We're on the same speed tier as that Charizard. So we outspeed a good bit of good Pokemon here. Things like Mimikyu, Excadrill, Form Change, Rotom, Duraludon, Gyarados, all of them not scarfed or anything like that. We outspeed, which is very good. Excadrill threatens us a lot, being able to have Rock Slide and super effective damage with, Rock Slide is super effective, but also having High Horsepower, Drill Run, or Earthquake, all of those moves being able to Oko us or knock us to our Sash, and typically played with Tyranitar. However, if it is played with Tyranitar and it's Sandstorm, then it's going to be outspeeding us if it's Sandrush. So, of course, Excadrill is good. Form Change Rotoms, we outspeed them unless they're Scarfed, which is good. Scarf has been trending down on all forms of Rotom. It's very typically going to be ran with Citrus Berry or something of that sort. A Guave Berry, maybe, like Pinch Berries. And so we'll usually be outspeeding Form Change Rotom. Duraludon, we 90% of the time outspeed. I haven't seen Scarf since like the first few weeks of Sword and Shield on the Duraludon, so it's good that we outspeed that. Gyarados also, you never see like Scarf, but after one Max Airstream, it is outspeeding us. So if you don't use Ninetales, Charizard as your lead, and then Max Airstream, then it's going to be outspeeding us the rest of, you know, until we do something like that. So Gyarados poses a bit of a threat, but we do outspeed it initially, which is very good. We can Will-O-Wisp it if you run that. Fake Tears kill it if you run that. However you really want to deal with it. Next, we have things that do outspeed us. Durant, Whimsicott, Cinderace, Inteleon, etc. All the Pokemon that are Scarfed, all the Pokemon that have doubling speed, things like Chlorophyll, Swift Swim, Unburden, anything like that, Scarfed Pokemon, 90% of Scarfed Pokemon will be outspeeding our Ninetales initially, which is unfortunate. Durant does feature a lot of super effective damage attacks. However, we do have Heat Wave, so if it attacks us, knocks us to our Sash, and then Heat Wave, and then potentially probably need another thing, although its special defense is abysmal, so we'll probably be able to Oko it with Heat Wave. Honestly, that's one of the damage calcs that I should have featured. I didn't have that featured, but I should have. Then we have Whimsicott, which doesn't really pose much of a threat to us. You know, it obviously has moves like Tailwind to do something beforehand, before we just kill it, but we can just Heat Wave, and then any attack just kills it, which is really good. You could even fake out Heat Wave, it would just kill it, which is really good. Then we have Cinderace and Inteleon. Both of them are trending down a lot last format in Season 2. They were both played, well, more so Inteleon, but they're both played very little now. However, they're still relevant and very strong Pokemon, and they both outspeed us, which is unfortunate. So that's going to be it for our speed tiers. We'll go ahead and talk about some damage calcs. I'll move up about halfway through these just so that you can see the bottom damage calcs make sense. I could always just get small. I guess I'll start doing that more, just getting small, so that you can see the whole thing. Anyway, Ninetales, Heat Wave, into Venusaur, in Sun. All of these are in Sun because of the fact that, you know, we set Sun when we come in, which kind of like half the gimmick of Ninetales, you know, so they're all with Sun active. So Ninetales, Heat Wave in Sun on a Venusaur, giving 85 to 103% damage, only a 25% chance to Oko. This is unfortunate that it doesn't have a guaranteed Oko or a higher chance at Okoing, but this is really good damage that we can get out onto a Venusaur, not even like requiring you to attack the Venusaur. You can hone in on the double, and then maybe this plus, you know, like, not really any of the paired, the main partners have multi-targeting attacks. Maybe, actually, so like, a lot of Charizards will run Heat Wave as well, so you can double Heat Wave, guaranteeing the knockout on the Venusaur, even if Dynamax, most likely, because Solar Power Charizard will be able to kill it anyway. Or Airstream into it, and then Heat Wave to knock it out for the finisher, because a lot will run Focus Sash, so that's another option as well. Then we have Solar Beam from our Ninetales into Rotom Wash, giving us a 90% chance to 2-hit KO after Citrus Berry recovery, hitting 59 to 71% chance, or 60 to 70%. Of their HP. So we have a really, really high chance of 2-hit KOing through Citrus Berry, which is really good. And this is just the most used Rotom spread that there is on Pikalytics. Next, we have Ninetales, Heat Wave. Oh, and all of these are damaged by Ninetales onto something else, because we pretty much assume that they're going to knock us to our Focus Sash or hit over 50% in 2-hit KOs. So almost everything is just like, oh, we're going to get 2-hit KOs, so we'll deal out some damage. So Heat Wave into Excadrill and Sun hits 101 to 120%, guaranteed Oko. However, if it Dynamaxes, it only hits about 50 to 60%. But if you Fake Tears and then follow up with a Heat Wave the next turn, you can guarantee knock it out, or Heat Wave it and then or Fake Tears and then Heat Wave by a Charizard can knock it out guaranteed, which is very good as well. Then we have Solar Beam and Milotic hitting 41-49%. Even with Fake Tears, we won't be able to guarantee an Oko, which is unfortunate. Solar Beam into Solid Rock Rhyperior hits 45-54%, about a 48% chance to Oko, to two hit KO. This is Dynamaxed Rhyperior, by the way. I should have added that. So Dynamaxed. But yeah, so it's Dynamaxed Rhyperior, so we're hitting a very good chance of two-hit KOing, and if you use the Fake Tears, we'll have about that percent of chance to Oko, which is pretty good as well. Next, we have Heat Wave into Rotom C, Rotom Mo, however you want to call it, in Sun, hitting 76-91% chance, or 76-91% of its HP, guaranteed 2-hit KO after Citrus Berry. However, there's no way for us to hit an Oko. We can with Fake Tears, but that's still 2-turn, like, essentially anyway, so whatever. Next, we have our single Spotlight that's going to finish off further damage costs. I went under that really quick. Anyway, single Spotlight. So this Pokemon, I don't think, is as good as it is in VGC, and it's pretty low tier in VGC as well, so it's not insane in singles, but it has some cool little things that it can do. So we're running Heavy Duty Boots, so it doesn't just die to Stealth Rocks and stuff when it goes in. And then we're running Nasty Plot, Toxic, Fire Blast, Solar Beam. Fire Blast, Solar Beam, you can switch out to like Flamethrower if you want, if you want that Fire Blast, like, to be more accurate. But Nasty Plot, so you pretty much just bring this in on a position where your opponent's going to have to switch out, reposition, or just, like, not do any damage or anything. And then you activate Nasty Plot. You start killing things with Fire Blast and Solar Beam. It can be a great wall breaker in that regard. It can also use Toxic on any kind of wall or anything, and then you just deal a lot of damage, passive damage, which is good. Other than that, the build is the same with Timid, max speed, and max special attack. That's going to be about it for this video. Ninetales is pretty cool in VGC and singles. I like the Pokemon a lot in VGC, being able to set Drought and then make two of the Kanto starters, Blastoise needs love too. Blastoise, I love you too. Don't worry. But Venusaur and Charizard get a lot of mileage off of having Sun, being able to double their speed or make a lot of an increase in power, which is really, really good. Ninetales can be really powerful and a cool Pokemon. If you don't want to use Torkoal, if you don't want to have a Trick Room team, a Trick Room mode on your team, you can just have a whole fast team of Sun. It's really good. Anyway, that's going to be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe if you want to. Do it. That's it. If you like Ninetales, like and subscribe. If you like this kind of content, like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. And comment down below if you want to see any Pokemon, any certain Pokemon or teams featured in future videos. I'm in lockdown now, so I can't really leave my house that much, so I need to make more videos. So give me ideas for videos, guys. Make it easy for me. Anyway, that's going to be it. Also, join the Discord if you want to. We have a couple of people in there. It's a pretty small community so far. However, we do bounce ideas off for competitive teams as far as and competitive builds for teams. You guys can directly contact me if you want to tell me, you know, whatever, like, hey, I like your videos. Hey, do this video. Here's an idea for a video. Shave your face, guy. You can say any of it. I don't care. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. That's going to be it. 3-minute outro. I think I shaved it down to 2 now. Anyway, bye.